July 25th, this is J.J. Roof, out of the town. I'm sitting here talking with Mike LeCompte.
Hello, hello, hello.
Mike, one thing we want to talk to you about is what recently happened. The record, and I mean record, amount of people that showed up for Pennypack Park Festival with your band headlining.
Oh, that was a great gig for us. I grew up right there on top of the park, the street, Rowland Avenue, so I hung out in that park as a kid. I saw concerts here. I saw Kris Kristofferson there when I was about 8 years old, and I saw Buddy Rich, lots of people, you know, all kinds of people would come there and play. Then they built the stage, and did concerts here in the 80s. We did some concerts there in the day. They recently, some years back, started having the concerts again and asked if we wanted to do one, and we usually did it with another band, but this one we did by ourselves. And just being from the neighborhood and having a good run with the band right now, it was a great turnout, and the Pennypack Park people were great to us in the Fairmount Park and the city. Everybody who had something to do with it, it was really nice people, you know, everybody. And it was a great turnout for us. I was tired that day. I came back from the shore exhausted, and I was overslept. I was sleeping at 6:30. And no one woke me up, and I looked at the clock and went, oh my God, 6:30, so I had to be on at 7. So I jumped up and drove down there, and it was a good show, I heard. People said it was really good. Well, you know, it's a good Northeast thing there, and I really appreciate that we could do that because, you know, it brings all those people together, a lot of people you don't see. Yeah, so that's about it at the concert. It was a nice night. It was a little hot, but, you know, people loved it, and I got a lot of good response from it. I was on the Angelo Bottoli show that morning. So that promoted it, too. He helped me promote it. So.
And I know Big Daddy always talks about it.
He does a good job. I just got off the phone with him. We're going to be down at the Brigada when the night the Who's there. We're going to be at the Brigada that night. And then tomorrow night we're at the Chump Deck. So we're having a pretty good run in the neighborhood today. Mike V helped us out a lot, too. He did a lot of promotion for me over the years. He did that park thing a lot together.
Mm-hmm. One question we'd like to ask. With so many musicians and bands have come and gone over the years, why Mike LeCompte? Why so strong still to this day?
Well, I think I've been lucky. Luck is a big factor. And I try to keep it together. I'm really into music. And, you know, it's my livelihood. And I have a family, too. And that's all goes into play. But a love for music and a love to compete and keep going, compete with all the younger bands, you know, and be surrounded by great musicians, Buddy, Jimmy, and Richie, all great players. And, you know, we do some freelance stuff like out there, some ad-lib improvisation. It takes it to another level. But a lot has to do with luck and perseverance and practicing and never giving up. And, you know, I mean, who knows, you know, but I've been lucky, and thank God, you know, for that.
What advice do you have for young musicians starting out tonight?
Well, try to keep their head clean, steer clear of different substances, and practice, listen to all kinds of music, and write songs, even if no one hears them, write them for yourself, and play with different musicians, you know, and just keep your eyes and ears open for stuff, because, you know, without music, we'd all be fucked.
Now, what's the best advice you ever received?
Well, my brother, who's a musician, had told me, you know, keep things simple when you're playing different soft drums, you know, rock or whatever, and just practice and listen, because you can learn something from anybody. I mean, I can learn something from some 16-year-old band that I go to see rehearsal, you know. You never stop learning. You know, you can learn from anybody, and that's the thing you have to remember. People get to a certain level, they think, well, so great and better, but, you know, I could go to hear something some young band is playing, go, wow, that's great, you know, I see what they did there, that's neat, you know, like a learning. So you have to keep you can't be shut down, you have to keep your eyes and ears open for learning, because every day's learning, every day we're vertical, we're learning something, right? Learn until you're laying sideways.
Who was some of your influences growing up? What started you in the business?
Well, like I said, my brother was a drummer, he's some years older than me, he's played with everybody. Stevie Wonder to play with Madonna, play with you know, Carole King, everybody. You know, you name the person. He's toured with them, played with them. He's toured with Art Garfunkel lately, and him. Then I had another brother who was into he was like sort of a singer. He's about 10 years older than me. He played. He had a band, and they listened to a lot of you know, have a big family. So there's 8 of us. So I'm the second youngest. So my oldest sister is in her 60s. I heard stuff from them, whether it was Supremes, Elvis. Then in my house, you could hear everything from to Elvis Presley to Alice Cooper to David Bowie to Paul Williams, you know, Carpenters, you know, The Who, whatever, you would hear it in my house. So I'm lucky in that way. At the time when I was a kid, like, you know, when you're into something as a kid, you're like, that sucks. But then you learn to appreciate it later on. I got into a lot of instrumental music, you know, like, you know, Jeff Beck and Mahamisha and all that kind of stuff. And just, you know, you always learn. Even now, there's so much music out every day. You know, you can never listen to it all, but you can definitely teach yourself and keep your eyes open. And it might inspire you to write something if you hear something from this or that. That's how music started. You know, the Beatles were somewhere. They heard this and, hey, man, I'm going to... Not steal that, but I'm getting that same vibe, you know, do that kind of thing.
Now, when you started out, am I correct to say that the majority of your work was all original?
Yeah.
Then you sort of ventured into cover and doing tributes?
Well, yeah, I always wrote songs. I always had a song. Whenever I played cover gigs, I always do a couple original songs. You know, I did all original gigs, too, and I had a record deal and with Tangier and everything, but it's hard. You know, you have to make a decision. Like, if you want to try to do this, and people will argue about this, say, you can't do those things. But you can be a raw songwriter, and you can play in bars, cover stuff. And you can do some of your own stuff. If people like one of your songs, all they got to do is like one of your songs. And then you can, you know, go to the next level, and you don't have to play, you know, you can play all original. But a lot has to do with supporting a family, too, you know. And, But I've been lucky in that way, too, where I can play original nights. I have enough songs to play all night original. I just opened up for Dave Mason by myself, you know, doing all originals. And I got a new CD coming out. It's like kind of folk rock, you know, pop type thing. And I've been lucky there, too, because, you know, if you have songs, if you have an arsenal of songs, which we do, and I do it all different kinds of styles, it might sound like you're mixed up, but you still write all kinds of... In genres of music, you know.
What do you like best about the business?
Nothing. Well, I like that it's, you know, that you almost call your own. You can pick where you want to play. At this point, I have a lot of good offers because the band's hot right now. I'm in the later start part of my life. I'm not like a kid anymore, but we're competing with a lot of young kids. But the business is not a nice business, you know. Comes down to it, the music is different than the business. There's great businessmen that are so on the music. I don't consider myself a great businessman. If I was, I might be, you know, sell a million records than I now. But, you know, too, business has a lot more to do with it than just the music. If you have good promotion, good publicists and all that stuff, and get the stuff out there and have a couple good little songs, you might get further. Like I said, I live and learn, you know.
What would you like to change about the music business if you could?
Well, the record business is over. There's no more record deals, really, unless you're a real young kid band and you get a big record deal. But they suck all the money out of them in production and video costs and everything. So even if you get a big record deal, you really can't be that successful unless you sell millions and millions of records. I would like to, you know, make it more independent radio where they would take more independent labels on radio, submit like stuff like that. But it's all about money. You know, big money, get some backing for radio, and they'll play your stuff. That still goes on.
Do you remember your first gig?
Yeah, it was a drumming. It was a drumming gig. It was a wedding, and it was my first paying gig. I was about 15, and my brother had to go somewhere, so I subbed for him. I thought I was pretty good, but I think they thought I sucked. They never called me back. I just laid it down, really. You know, I did some. It was a wedding, and I did some of this and some of that, but I can remember that gig. I was about 15, yeah, it was scary, very scary.
How does Michael Kopp want to be remembered?
As, you know, a hard-working musician, you know, that people like to come and see and like, entertain people, and, like, I would like to be remembered as a songwriter, but I haven't written anything that is out there big enough, but, you know, it's still time to do that. And that's what I do. I'm trying to write right now. I was recording last night a song that I'm submitting to somebody. It's a song for another artist, but, you know, I'm recording. I got to end with this thing. But I don't know. That's a tough question. As a, you know, just a decent person, a good guy, you know, help people and, you know, good father, you know how it is.
If you weren't a musician, what other career could you see yourself doing or did you think about doing?
I never thought about that. I'd like to play baseball.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You'd be surprised some of the answers I got. Like Lou Graham told me he was going to be a teacher.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. I never thought about it. I guess, I don't know. It's just, I like sports. I would love to be, you know, never good enough, but I played baseball as a kid. I love baseball, but, teaching is hard. It's a hard thing. I know teachers, and I teach a couple people, but that's hard. What would you like to be?
I guess an actor, which I'm getting back into it.
Right. Yeah. That would be nice, too. Yeah. I did some acting.
Did you?
Yeah. I did an episode of Miami Vice as like an extra years ago in the 82, I went to some acting lessons and stuff, but I would like to get into that.
Well, you've done videos, correct?
Yeah.
Which is a form of acting.
Yeah, posing. But, I'm doing a video now soon coming up for the song Louisiana Wind, so.
What is your most cherished instrument, possession that you own? Everybody has one guitar or one thing they love.
I have a Steinway grand piano.
Wow. That
I was very lucky to get. I bought it off a convent. They gave me a real good deal on it. It was a 1927 Steinway Model M, and I had it refurbished, the whole thing, and it's amazing. That's bad, Plus, I have my first guitar still. It's a classic guitar. And that's a big deal. It's not worth a lot, but it's a big deal to me.
Exactly.
But the piano it sounds great.
Yeah. And to all your fans, Mike, out there who followed you religiously throughout the years, what would you like to say to them?
I would like to say they are the best. Thank you so much for keeping it going and believing in the music and hanging with me for these years. And I can never thank them enough. And I love them, It's great people. A lot of nice people come to see me. And anything I could do for them, I would.
Cool. Great.
Thank you. Yeah.